In this vicious volatile market, do you know what hung in there today? You know what actually went up today? I'll tell you, Federal Realty, FRT, the best shopping center real estate investment trust in the United States, secure dividend that yields 2.84%, roughly equal with the return for the 30-year U.S. Treasury after today's gigantic decline in interest rates. Let's take a closer look with Don Wood, the president and CEO of Federal Realty Investment Trust, who's a visionary in this industry. Hear more about how his company's doing and where it is headed. Mr. Wood, welcome back to Mad Money.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you so much, Don.
Great to see you again.
Good to see you likewise.
Don, you know, one of the things that's happened during this period since we talked last is there's been a lot of challenge, not to the idea, Amazon versus stores, but challenge to the idea that the shopping center has lost its relevance. You seem to recognize that and are doing some things, including something you announced today, to change the perspective, at least for your group, on this issue.
Yeah, you know, first of all, I think really when you hear the internet is killing retail.
Right.
I think that's really shorthand, and I think it's shorthand for consumer behavior is changing. And I couldn't agree more that consumer behavior is changing. And I don't think that the two things are disconnected. I think when you look today at consumer behavior, what you see are folks that really are really concerned about efficiency.
Okay.
They're really concerned about value. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean value as cheap. I mean value. You're getting something for the dollar that you
right.
spend. And I also think social interaction is becoming more and more important. And I kind of, if you kind of think about it and think about the last 10 years and where the world has gone and what has happened, restaurants, chef-driven restaurants mm-hmm. have done better and better
right.
and better.
Personal personality.
Lifestyle type of things where people don't have to be in their car all the time, places where they can actually work, where they can actually play, where they can actually shop, where they can actually maybe even stay in a hotel and live are more and more fruitful, if you will.
Let's start with that, because Hilton's new brand arrived at Pike and Rose, one of yours. There would be a time when I would think the last thing I would want is to live with a mall or stay with a mall, but now I think it's kind of an exciting thing. I saw it in Egypt once. I saw it in some Central European places, but not here.
When you talk about shopping generally and you think about the different businesses, there is no question that the mall business, the enclosed mall business, which is a business which is highly dependent upon women's fashions,
right.
other
right.
things too, but women's right. fashions, that business is a completely different business than the business that we're in. Now, you know, we don't have any malls, but all of this has come out and you know, what's the future of the mall? The only thing what I would say, and I do have an awful right. lot of friends in the mall business, is that I don't think I would want to own the second best mall in a town, you know, right. that can support only one.
Right, and the shopping center's always been your bailiwick, and
sure.
it's a better bailiwick.
Well, it's better or not, when I sit and I think about consumers and behavior and where that's going, it's environment, it's a place, it's a real place. And when you think about a hotel like Canopy and what right. Hilton is doing here, it's a perfect match. And when you kind of think about that lifestyle and open mm-hmm. floor plan where that basically changes when you go in the morning versus what you can have there in the afternoon and the evening on a street that is vibrant, on a place where we have great rooftop music mm-hmm. venues, where we have theaters and luxury theaters, where we have great shopping, great restaurants.
Right.
Together, that all seems to work.
Okay. All right. Now, you mentioned that people like social contact. We know people gather. You and I have known each other a long time, so I don't feel like I can... I think it's okay to ask you this.
Anything you want.
When you have an outbreak of Ebola
uh-huh.
Or SARS, because you've lived through everything, SARS hurt the shopping business. Now, you have, on all your reports, you always say the same thing. Listen, I don't care about the day-to-day, which is right. Is this a day-to-day issue that you can care about, but you also have to think that it's going to be solved?
Well, I do. I do. Listen, first of all, the Ebola breakout, it's just devastating. It's a terrible thing. I'm glad I live here. I'm certainly glad we live in this country, and certainly what the CDC is right. doing with respect to how healthcare providers have to take care of themselves
right.
when they do that. You can be sure that that's you know, job number one.
But is
right
it
now.
A behavior changer?
It's not. I don't see it as a behavior changer for any long term period of time. And you know, we talk about this a lot, Jim. The idea of us being in the real estate business rather than in the retail business
right.
means we look at things over the longer term.
Right, which is why that yield is safe, which is why you've been honest the whole way and why it's really been a fantastic
stock.
I'll
say one thing.
Today.
Let me say one thing to you.
Yeah.
It's been three times in a row I've come on this show over the past couple of years when the market has either died significantly during the day or it's been very volatile. I just want to apologize to investors all over the world because it can't be a coincidence, can it?
No.
It's got to have something to do with
it. It is you. You're not coming. No, I don't want to see you again. Well, maybe on an update. That's Don Wood, President and CEO of Federal Realty Investment Trust. Longer term. Hey, that's an idea, isn't it? Stick with Kramer.